In this video, we'll cover the basics of configuring the DevExtreme DX TreeMap widget. The DX TreeMap widget provides all the functionality required to display your data in an easily readable visual form. You can specify TreeMap colors automatically. The widget provides three algorithms for tile colorization: discrete, gradient, and range. The widget uses rectangles whose sizes are proportional to the visualized values. Like any widget from the DevExtreme library, the DX TreeMap widget can be added using the jQuery, AngularJS, or knockout approach. Here, I'm using the jQuery approach. I've already created a simple web page and added references to the following libraries: jQuery, CLDR, Globalize, and DevExtreme. Now we need to add the DX TreeMap widget to a page and set up a data source for it. I've already prepared an array of objects representing hierarchical TreeMap data. Let's assign this array to the widget's data source configuration option. Now let's see how the DX TreeMap looks with the specified data and default settings. You can see colored rectangles with text information. Now I'll specify the title and the name of the data source field that provides text for tile and group labels. And let's look at the result again. Now, the tree map looks a little better. The DX TreeMap widget can also use an array that has a plane structure. I've prepared another array of objects representing plane TreeMap data. Each data item has a key field whose value is unique within the entire array. Let's change the data sources configuration option to use a plane array as a data source. I'll also define the ID field and parent ID options, which hold the key value of the parent item. And let's see the result. Now let's manage the TreeMap color settings. I'll define the possible colorization options. The type option specifies the colorizing algorithm. The palette option sets the palette to be used for colorizing the tiles. The colorize groups option specifies whether or not all tiles in a group must be colored uniformly. This applies only if the type option is discrete. The range option allows you to paint tiles with similar values uniformly. This applies only if the type option is gradient or range. I'll set the discrete algorithm as a colorizer for the tree map. And add a DX select box to change the colorization algorithm at runtime. Okay, let's see how colorization works. The discrete algorithm is the simplest. It paints each tile within a group in a color taken from the palette. If I select the gradient algorithm, the palette contains only two colors that will be used to colorize the smallest and largest tiles respectively. Other tiles will have a tint of either the first or second color depending on their size. The range algorithm is similar to gradient, but the array assigned to the range option contains more than two values. This colorizer assigns a color to the TreeMap item depending on a range to which the TreeMap item value belongs. Finally, I'll specify the layout algorithm used to locate TreeMap items. The squareified algorithm is used by default. I'll set the layout algorithm option to slice and dice. And as you can see, the slice and dice layout algorithm divides the space between items, slicing it in the specified direction depending on the item value. And that's it. To learn more about the elements of the DevExtreme widget and ways to customize it, refer to our documentation on our website. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.